Tucker Carlson, with each passing day, is becoming a little crazier every single day. This week, after doing a ridiculous tirade about masks and how it reduces oxygen flow to your brain, which maybe, hey, maybe that explains a lot about Tucker Carlson, but either way, after he did this little tirade, he started talking about the fact that he wants to see Dr. Anthony Fauci criminally prosecuted for being responsible for the pandemic. Not just for the pathetic pandemic response from the Trump administration when Fauci was involved with that. No. Tucker Carlson went so far as to imply that Anthony Fauci is actually responsible for the pandemic itself. And it's based on some pretty questionable reporting that says that all the way back in, I think it was like 2014, the United States gave money to this health institute overseas. That institute then contracted a lab in Wuhan to do some research on viruses and bats. And of course, Dr. Fauci was a part of that administration. That would have been the Obama administration. And by extension, Tucker says, obviously, you know, the Wuhan lab created the virus and then released it, but they did it because Fauci's group gave them money 7 years ago or 6 years ago, I guess, by the time the pandemic hit. It's insane. Like, all of this is pure conspiracy theory that has no basis in reality, but Tucker Carlson is out there every night stating it as if it's a concrete fact and now going as far as saying, I've made up this thing in my head, and based on this made up thing, I now want Fauci criminally prosecuted. I was thinking about Tucker Carlson earlier today, you know, researching this story and all that, and I think I've come up with an explanation as to what's happening here. Tucker Carlson is basically Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. And I say that because there was a time, really not all that long ago, that Tucker Carlson was actually seen as a moderate Republican, had his little show on MSNBC. I know Mike Papantonio went on it all the time. And Tucker Carlson would listen to the progressive talking points that Pap was stating on the air, and he would agree with some of them, and he would build upon some of them. He was actually reasonable. But then when he went to Fox, this other personality, the Mr. Hyde personality, came out. It started off small, but in the last few years, Hyde has grown more and more evil, getting more and more extreme, and you don't see old Dr. Jekyll, original MSNBC Tucker Carlson anymore, do you? Because that Hyde personality has taken over. And Tucker Carlson no longer has any control over it. You know, it's like his mind is at war with itself. And the Mr. Hyde personality is the one that has taken over. This is now who he is. This is now what he believes, and it is now what he stands for. And Fox News won't do a dang thing about it, because even with his advertising exodus, Tucker Carlson still makes them tons of cash. They're rolling in the dough from local carriers who run Fox News, you know, the Fox News network. They pay to have that done. And that's the money that compensates for Tucker Carlson not being able to get quality advertisers. But Tucker Carlson has gone off the deep end. This is who he is now. And maybe the Dr. Jekyll personality of the early years, maybe that was the fake one. Maybe that was the persona he was putting on for the air, and he dropped it and became this monster. I don't know which is which. But all I do know is that all we're left with now is this monster who is out there every day spouting lies and conspiracies and things that make absolutely no sense. And for some reason, his audience absolutely loves it. Thanks for watching. And if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.